Hi guys, I'm Akash Roth and welcome to Akash Biology. And in this video tutorial, we will be dealing about the fate of ovarian follicles. So you can have access to my previous video that is on the video of oogenesis on my page, that is Akash Biology on a Facebook page, links are below. So in this video, we'll be dealing about the fate of ovarian follicles. So as we all know, what happens in the process of oogenesis, that is the primary germinal cell is being converted into the ova. Now we will be dealing about the what are the various stages that undergo the ova. So first of all, what happens? So there is single oocyte, and in the ovary, before dealing onto the structures, we have to know about the ovary. So ovary has two parts: the outer one, that is the cortex, and the inner one is the medulla. So the ovarian follicles or the primordial follicles or any of the maturations of the oocytes takes place in the cortex, that is the outer part of the ovary. Why on the outer part? Because it has to rupture at some point of time, so it is easy to rupture from the cortex. So let us see, whenever there is a ova, what? Ova. So there is a oocyte, so oocyte has to take some nutrients, or it has some demands. So what happens? Some of the cells of stroma, that is the from the medulla, from the inner portions of the ovary, will go into the cortex and will form the line. What? Will form the line like this. It will align like this. So these are first columnar types of cells. What? Columnar types of cells. And this one is the oocyte. So any oocyte that is surrounded by a single layer of follicular cells or the stromal cells is known as primordial follicle. What? Primordial follicle. Primordial follicle. So when a child is born, it is born with what? Or he or she is born with what? Primordial follicle. Now coming on to the puberty. What? Puberty. So what happens? These follicular cells has got two functions. First of all, to provide nutrition to the oocyte. Similarly, to inhibit the oocyte to present only in the meiosis first of prophase. What? Diploty. In order to inhibit what? Meiosis type of cell divisions. So this is the work of what? Follicular cells. So we will write the two functions of follicular phase. First of all, nutritional functions. Second one is inhibition of meiosis first. What? Meiosis first. What? Of the prophase. Now the child has undergone into the puberty stage. What? Puberty stage or the adolescence stage. So what happens? In the hypothalamus is what? Gonadotropin releasing hormone, that is 10 amino acid peptide. It will secrete intermittently. So I will drop this. So what? First of all, from the hypothalamus. Hypothalamus. So hypothalamus will secrete what? GnRH, that is gonadotropin releasing hormone. So every releasing hormone is secreted by what? The hypothalamus. Now hypothalamus will act on what? Pituitary gland. What? Pituitary gland, that is the anterior pituitary. Now anterior pituitary will secrete two hormones, that is the follicle stimulating hormone, second one is the LH hormone. But in the first phase, it will secrete what? FSH hormone. What? FSH hormone, because we can to focus on the development of the ovarian follicle. What? Development on the ovarian follicle. So when a child is born with a single primordial stage, so we have to just make a figure. So this one is the oocyte with the nucleus. Now there are various follicular cells. What? Follicular cells over here. So first of all, they are columnar. Now what happens? There is a oocyte has also plasma membrane, that is known as vitelline membrane. What? Vitelline membrane. Now in between this vitelline membrane and the follicular cells, another layer of covering, that is a glycoproteinase covering, will start to form. So first of all, so we can see this is what? Oocyte having the vitelline membrane. This is often called the primary membrane, because primary membrane are the membranes that are secreted by the ovary itself. So vitelline membrane is the primary membrane that is secreted by ovum. So just remember this, were mainly asked in the entrance examinations. Now outside the vitelline membrane, what we can see? There is another covering. What? Another covering. but another covering. So this covering is a glycoproteinase in nature, and outside the covering there is what? Follicular type of cells. What? Follicular types of cells. So this is a typical oocyte. So we can see innermost black one is the vitelline membrane. Second one is what? The zona pellucida. What? Zona pellucida. It is a glycoproteinase covering. What? Glycoproteinase covering. And it is the secondary membrane. What? Secondary membrane. Secondary membrane, because it is secreted by the ovary. What? Ovary, not by the ovum. So when secreted by the ovum, it is primary membrane. When secreted by the ovary, it is known as secondary membrane. And when secreted by the female genital tract or the reproductive system, that is known as the tertiary membrane. That is the case of cell, the cleidonic eggs. And this one is the follicular cells having the basal nucleus. Now what happens? As the oocyte is undergoing increase in size, because after puberty there is a more secretion of what? FSH. So FSH will act on the follicular cells. Now what happens? These follicular cells will start to grow. So these are just glycoproteinase cover. So this will form on the layer. What? Various layers. That is a stratification of cells. So first of all, this is a columnar, then becomes a cuboidal, then forms the stratified. So we can see various layer of cells. So these cells are known as what? Granulosa cells. What? Granulosa cells. Granulosa cells. So granulosa cells and follicular cells are same. They are the cells from the stroma. But difference is that whenever there is a single layer of cells, it is known as follicular cells. When the follicular cells has multiple layer, it is known as granulosa cells. Now what happens? Inside the granulosa cell, there forms the various gaps. What? Various gaps. We can see various gaps over here. Now these all gaps will combine to form a bigger gap. What? Bigger gap. And that will form the vesicular nuclei. What? Vesicular follicle. So what happens after the, so let's say this, now this will forms like this vesicular. There one a oocyte, that is the ovum, and these are all the follicular cells. What? Follicular cells. These all are follicular cells. You might get bored because my drawing is terrible. So these all are follicular cells. This one is the gap, and this gap is known as antrum. What? Antrum. So any follicle with an developed antrum is known as what? Graafian follicle. And all this process takes place in the cortex of the ovary. Now what happens? There are two types of follicular cells. So one is located just close to the antrum. So this is known as cumulus ophoricus. Ophoricus. So may be asked, what is the follicular cells that is attached to the ovary, ovum, and located just near to the antrum? That is the cumulus ophoricus. And which is located just distal to the opposite or 180 degree to the antrum is known as discus proligerus. Proligerus. I don't know why they are given the names. They are actually the all are the follicular cells. Now what happens? First of all, there is secretion of what? FSH. So FSH at the time of puberty will act on the follicular cells. Now follicular cells will undergo positive feedback. Positive feedback in the sense that all the follicular cells again act on the GnRH or the anterior pituitary to secrete more FSH. So they increase in the number of FSH receptors. So one FSH at the time of puberty, when the FSH is secreted, it has diffuse effect. So it will allow the 10 or 12 follicles to grow at a time. What? 10 or 12 follicles, primary follicles to grow at a time. 10 to 12 follicles to grow at a time, and all the follicles will grow simultaneously. Now in this antrum there is a presence of a fluid known as the follicular fluid. So when FSH acts on the follicular cells or granulosa cells, so it will secrete what? Estrogen. What? Estrogen. Now we have to see, now both will act on the follicular cells, FSH as well as estrogens. So it will both have result on what? What? the positive feedback effect. Until and unless we can see there is no role of LH over here. Now comes the function of LH. Now at the time of ovulations, at the time of ovulations means at the 14th day of menstrual cycle, and the day is counted from the day of bleeding. So at the 14th day, what happens? There is a rupture of, they start to increase in size. What? They start to increase in size. When they start to increase in size, they will create more effect, more diffuse effect on the follicular cells. So follicular cells over here become thin and it's try to rupture. Means, so let's say this is a ovary. Now it will come out, the ovary will protrude like this, and this it forms like a nipple, and this is known as stigma. What? Stigma. So it will just pinch out from here. Now the, and why it occurs? Just prior to 2 days before the ovulation, or 16 hours before the menstrual ovulations, the LH secretions will increase. What? LH secretions will increase. LH. So what does the LH do? So normally what the follicular cells will secrete? It will secrete estrogen. But LH, that is luteinizing hormone, will cause the follicular cells to secrete progesterone. What? Progesterone. Now progesterone has got what? Proteolytic property. Proteolytic means it will just digest the collagen protein on the side of ovarian follicle. So the ovarian follicle wall becomes thin. Ovarian follicle wall becomes thin. And what happens? If there is also the increase in the transduction, so increase in the space between the follicular cells. So more plasma will go into the follicular cells. Now there is increase in the pressure and they will try to rupture. So it will secrete just 16 hours or 2 days prior to what? Ovulations. Now as we have told earlier, the 10 to 12 follicles start to grow, but at the time proceed towards ovulations, the FSH will have the negative feedback. What? One of the strongest follicles, which has got the more FSH receptors, it acts on the pituitary to decrease the FSH hormone to all other sites, only to one site. What is 10 to 12 follicles? So one is stronger, it will inhibit or just inhibit all other follicles. So that's how only one follicle grows. But there is a starting of 10 to 12 follicles, but only one grows. What? Maturations. So that follicles which will what? Which will undergo degenerations, there is no FSH in that. So they are known as what? What they are known as? Corpus atresia. What? Corpus atresica, or some to say atresia, because they has not undergo the process of maturation. Before ovulation they will degenerate. So corpus atresia or corpus atrechica are the follicles that has not undergo ovulation. They has degenerated. Now what happens? So let's say the ovum is ruptured from here. So the ovulation is due to what? LH. What? LH. But the maturation is due to FSH and estrogen. What? Estrogen. Now in the female genital, female fallopian tube or genital tract reproductive systems, the ovum will go into what? The fallopian tube, and due to the fimbrial actions, and now but the follicular cells will reside inside the ovary. What? Ovary. So now we will just focus on the follicle, not on the ovum. So what happens in the ovum? So let's say this is the fallopian tube. So let's say ovum is here, but the ovary, inside the ovary, first of all the follicular cells be like this. And I have just forgot to tell you what happens. So let's say this is the follicle and this is the ovum and this is the follicle. Now outside the follicle there are again the spindle cells or the stromal cells will come, and it will rearrange into the two layers. What? Two layers. One is inside layer, another is the outside layer. So inside layer is known as theca interna, and the outside is known as theca externa. So theca interna has an endocrine function, so it will secrete again estrogens. So I have told you earlier the follicular cells will secrete estrogens. It is due to the action of theca interna. Whereas theca externa has got the connective tissue, that is vascular in nature. So when the ovum will rupture, so there will again rupture of the theta externa, and there will be some bleeding in the peritoneal or the retroperitoneal sac, and that is known as, so that what that follicle after the rupture there is a bleeding, so it is known as corpus hemorrhagia. What? Corpus hemorrhagia. Now what happens after sometimes, there is again effect of LH, as the ovum go into the fallopian tube or the follicle inside the ovary. So what happens under the actions of LH, the cells become crumbled and folded. What? Crumbled and folded, and will secrete a yellowish pigment. What? Yellowish pigment known as lutein. What? Lutein. And this, and the yellow lutein has a fat, some pigment yellow in color, and it has accumulated some fat in it. So that's why it is known as corpus luteum. What? Corpus luteum of menstruations. What? Menstruations. Because as the second, it is said in the secondary oocyte stage, now it will go into the uterus, or it will reside over here for some time. If the sperm will not come, so it will reside inside the fallopian tube or the uterus for 14 days. In that days, the nutrition to the ovum is provided by what? This corpus luteum. And this corpus luteum secretes what? Progesterone. What? Progesterone. And it will wait for the sperm to come. But even after the 14 days, if the sperm has not fertilized the ovum, that is secondary, that is said in secondary oocyte stage, the ovum will, the corpus luteum will undergo degenerations, and it is known as corpus albicans. What? Corpus albicans. So again, the corpus albicans is what? Follicular cells. But it has gone undergone the process of what? Corpus hemorrhagia, then corpus luteum, and the if the fertilization is not occurring, then it will become the corpus albicans, which has no more the function of secreting the progesterone. But in case if the sperm will come and just fertilize in the ampulla of fallopian tube, this corpus luteum will not regress. It will become the corpus luteum of pregnancy. What? Corpus luteum of pregnancy. And it will continue to secrete progesterone until unless with what time? It will secrete the progesterone up to the 3 to 4 months of pregnancy. 3 to 4 months of pregnancy. And after that, the corpus luteum pregnancy will degenerate. Why? Because the maturations to the maturations and the nutrition is given by what? Placenta secreting HCG hormone, human corticogonadotropin hormone, that is secreted by the placenta. So after 3 or 4 months of intrauterine life, the maturations or the nutritions to the zygote is given not by the corpus luteum pregnancy, it is given by the placenta, because you secrete the HCG hormones. And this is a basis of what? Pregnancy test, HCG hormone, often known as Gravidex test. What? Gravidex test. So this video is all about the fate of ovarian follicle. I hope you have understood this video. If this video is helpful to you, then please like and tap the subscribe button for more videos. And I always think this is the video lesson that is have the special facilitated topics on demand. So you can comment your topic and we'll try to make as soon as possible. Stay tuned and connected with Akash Biology, and thank you.